Good afternoon. I'm Senator Chang Diaz. In light of tonight's public hearing regarding the MBTA's proposed fare increases, I'd like to take a moment to voice my concerns that I have not only for my own constituents, but the Commonwealth at large. Many Bay Staters rely on the MBTA as their primary and often only mode of transportation, and I'm deeply concerned that the options offered by the T's Control Board will disproportionately impact vulnerable and low-income individuals. I'll be among the first to agree that the T needs proper investment and about the urgency for generating T revenue. At the same time, our transportation infrastructure, which yields huge statewide economic benefits, should not be funded on the backs of the urban poor. I was a co-sponsor of the amendment 3 years ago that created the fare increase cap. It was absolutely the Senate's intent to limit the increases to no more than 5% every 2 years. So I urge the T Control Board to act in accordance with the advocates and the public's understanding of this amendment when it was passed. Don't succumb to the soundbite analysis that the T's riders are its only beneficiaries. Last winter and the economic paralysis that came with the T's shutdown soundly disproved that notion. Sharing responsibility for our transit infrastructure broadly, just as we broadly share its benefits, was good public policy in 2013, and it's good public policy now. To riders, to residents, and look, to all who like to breathe clean air and enjoy the fruits of a healthy economy, I urge you to turn out to tonight's meeting of the T Fiscal Management and Control Board, or join me next Wednesday, February 10th, at Roxbury Community College for the next public meeting of the board, where I will stand with advocates in addressing these fair proposals and their impacts on our communities. You can find specifics on both these meetings on my website, senatorchangdiaz.com. I hope to see you there.